urge unite for reproductive and gender equity. I am so excited to have over 70 young people coming to the Capitol today to lobby their representatives about abortion access. We have over 12 colleges and universities being represented here today. We're here in the state capitol to lend our voices to a cause we all care so much about, reproductive health care and access to abortion in Ohio. As many of you may know, there's been an endless onslaught of attempts to shut down, shut out, and shut up the patients and providers of abortion clinics in Ohio. Now it's time for our voices to be heard as we say that hatred and violence should have no bearing on how and when we receive the health care that we need. No one should have to hear the hate-filled speech simply for going to see their doctor. It's time that we demand each person in Ohio to have the ability to control their own health and their own bodies. It's time to make Ohio work for us. Who's ready to make their voices heard in the state house today? So we don't stand alone here in this fight today. We are so lucky to have the support of community leaders like the Founders Women's Health Center and NARAL Pro-Choice Ohio here today. And we are so fortunate to have the support of State Senator Capri Cafaro, a native Ohioan. Senator Cafaro has worked tirelessly to advance sexual assault awareness and women's rights in our state. I'm so proud and excited to introduce Senator Cafaro.
Thank you. Thank you. So the mic goes down. First, I want to thank all of you for coming out and lending your voice to what has turned into an endless fight and struggle to protect what is already a constitutionally protected right in the state of Ohio and across the country for our reproductive freedom of choice. I don't think it's any secret to many of you in this room that I have been an outspoken advocate for women's health and certainly against the defunding of Planned Parenthood in the state of Ohio. Trying to emphasize the fact that this is about even more than abortion access. This is about access to health care for women that is going to be curtailed when Governor Kasich signs into law the defunding Planned Parenthood bill. So the implications for women trying to get cancer screenings, trying to get mammograms, trying to get access to contraception, is going to be significantly impacted by, you know, what I believe is a red herring in regards to the fight to fund Planned Parenthood. I also want to say a word about prevention. I have introduced a bill in this General Assembly, but I've introduced it several times over my almost 10 years in office. This General Assembly, it's Senate Bill 101, and that is commonly referred to as prevention first. It would help develop medically accurate, age-appropriate, comprehensive sex education in the schools. And that is critically important because if we want to reduce the number of unintended pregnancies, we need to make sure that our young people understand what kind of access they have for contraception and understanding their bodies, understanding what they need to do to protect themselves. And so, to me, if we want to be serious about things like infant mortality, if we want to be serious about reducing unintended pregnancies, if we want to be serious about making sure that we continue to control the cost of healthcare spending, particularly in Medicaid, then we need to ensure that we are doing what we can to empower women and men alike to have access to contraceptive care, because this is an important tool that we have to do all of these things, to reduce infant mortality, to ensure appropriate pregnancy spacing, and to ensure that we have the ability to raise children in an environment that is financially sound and secure, and so we can all be contributing members of society. So to me, that all sounds like common sense, and which should be something that everyone can agree upon. Unfortunately, Senate Bill 101, just like every single other time I've introduced this bill, has not seen the light of day. We've had a few conversations with other members, but we really have not gotten any traction. So I would suggest, as you go around, remind folks about Senate Bill 101, the Prevention First Bill, because again, if we want to make sure that we continue to reduce health costs, if we want to make sure that we are combating our egregious infant mortality rate, and we want to make sure that folks are contributing to the economy, we need access to comprehensive, medically accurate sex education, because that's where it starts. So good luck to all of you today. Your voice is needed in this fight, and look forward to hearing from all of you, and thank you for participating in democracy.
Thank you so much, Senator, and we couldn't be happier with your support today. So next up, I'd like to introduce you to one of Urge's best, Khadija Kirksey. Khadija is a student leader at Wright State University and has been working with Urge for over a year now. Help me in welcoming Khadija to the stage.
Today, we stand in solidarity, not only in support of House Bill 408, but also in defense of humanity. We are here in defense of every person's freedom of choice, equity, and safe access to the healthcare services that they need. Reproductive health clinics need the protection of the law to ensure that people can access healthcare that is safe and affordable. No one should ever have to be confronted with harassment and fear every time that they visit their doctor. We do not plead, we protest. We protest any infringement upon any person's safety. We organize in support of legislation that will protect people's safety and access, such as House Bill 408. And we unite. We unite young people across Ohio, across the nation, who advocate for what is just. Indeed, there is nothing more American than choice. There is nothing more American than equity and safety and the protection of those constitutional rights. We came here to Columbus today to demonstrate that we stand in solidarity with abortion providers, with persons who seek the services of abortion providers, with the patients, and with clinics across Ohio. We stand here in solidarity today, and we urge everyone to do the same. Thank you.